I don't know. It's starting to smell really good in here, mainly due to what's coming out of the kitchen right now.
That's right. We're going to head over to Vic and see what's happening over there. Hey, guys.
Hey, I am with Chef Christoph von Wagner, and you and your husband, Kirk, are owners and operators of Curly's Grill and Banquet Center in Lackawanna.
Yep.
What road?
We're on Ridge Road.
Ridge Road.
Conveniently located next door to the Basilica, Owelli Basilica,
oh,
and
everybody
the Botanical
knows
Gardens.
That is. There you go. Now, everybody knows that you also have a lot of products that you do. You have a Caribbean flair. Today, we're going to go Italian. We're going to do a puttanesca.
Very good.
And you're pushing, though, health.
Yes, I am pushing health. Healthy choice. And look for that on your menus. There's a lot of restaurateurs that have joined in with us through the Erie County Board of Health. We're sponsoring a program. And I promise you, and they make strict guidelines, that it can only have so many calories. I just went online and plugged in all my ingredients, and it approved it, and I got a little sticker, and I put it on my menu items.
And if you can't go to the restaurant, you can make this one on your own.
This is a great dish.
Let's put it together.
This is a great dish. Okay, I'm going to start out with some olive oil. Okay.
Does it matter, olive oil?
This is an extra virgin.
And okay. That's the best?
You know what? I'm saving the best for last because I'm going to finish it with it.
I did try that.
I talked with Kirk, and he's like, please, Krista, that's not for cooking. Just finish things with it.
Okay.
Especially the price I paid. Mm. Peppers, your choice. What kind of peppers do you want to use? I use bananas.
Banana peppers.
Okay, whatever you want to use. It really doesn't matter.
Just any kind? Peppers. Green peppers?
Yeah. Throw some peppers in there. How about some olives?
And all chopped up.
Yeah, I got to get that back in there. That's for the end. And let's add some anchovy. And I know you're going to be laughing at me, but just a little. Chopped. Dump those capers in there.
All of them?
Yeah.
Love capers.
Go ahead. And now we're going to add that mixture that we made.
That you...
Tell us what
Cuisine Art. It's the roasted tomatoes.
Yes.
A special sweet tomato. Can't remember which
Campari.
One. Campari sweet tomatoes and the roasted garlic.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
And it's all full of flavor. Look at that.
Look at that.
Can always just make this up. This mixture right here, simmer it for about just a couple minutes.
Okay.
And we're going to finish it with those diced tomatoes. Could you dump those in there for me?
Absolutely.
Okay. And how about some fresh parsley?
Dump
you
that
could
in
use
there too.
Basil if you want, parsley. But do something green and promise me, Victoria, it'll be fresh.
Fresh.
Okay.
There's a difference between the dried and the fresh.
Absolutely. It's two different worlds.
That's great to know.
Two different worlds. I cooked up penne.
Okay.
And we're going to add that now. Let me just taste this, Victoria. Let's see what we got going on here.
Yeah, me too.
Isn't that just...
Oh, so many flavors.
Yes, and you can't find that anchovy.
You can't taste it at all. I was a little concerned about the anchovy.
No, don't worry about it. They put anchovy in Worcestershire sauce. Do you know that?
I didn't know that.
Okay.
And you said A1 sauce as well?
Yeah, it's a secret component they use in manufacturing.
It's not a secret anymore.
Okay. Here we go. I guess I could put more. There's a big studio here.
Yeah,
okay.
Everybody
How's
leads
that look?
Them. Excellent.
Put that back? Okay, this is just about ready. I'm going to toss this up, and we're going to finish it with some fresh grated pecorino romano cheese. I'll put it in the bowl. I want you to do that. Let me just toss this first, okay?
Okay.
This just takes a second.
Now, you have won numerous awards, from the Taste of Buffalo People's Choice Awards. You've won a Business First Under 40 Award, Culinary Awards. You're a graduate of the CIA. You know what you're talking about when you're talking about food, and you want to promote healthy eating. And we're going to talk about desserts, too, today.
I can't wait. My second helping, we're using leftovers. And the leftover cheese is what we're going to talk about right in your hand.
Wow.
Now, watch this.
Okay.
I went to one of those specialty olive oil stores.
I tried this earlier.
Oh, my gosh. This is from Prima Olivia. And this olive oil is like straight from Italy. Straight from Italy. It hasn't sat in the warehouses and the bottles.
Fresh.
It is unbelievable. It totally freaked me out. There were so many choices, I just didn't know what to do. They also sell the balsamic vinegars, too. Okay, here we go. Don't burn yourself. I got that burner on.
Look at that.
Let me just put that right there.
Shave some.
Don't burn yourself, Victoria. There we go.
I don't want to catch on fire.
Yeah, no.
I would still eat the pasta on
Your
fire.
Husband would kill me.
Yeah. I'm not so sure today.
And this is simplicity. This is a beautiful dish. And everything that you used.
More cheese. I will, but you know what? I have to try it. This is my favorite part.
Is it? Oh, you go ahead. It's warm.
Oh, my goodness. That is amazing. It does need more cheese, though, Joe.
And I do hope that everybody here, I proved you how simple this can be, and I want you to try it at home.
And you didn't add any salt.
No, because the anchovy, that's another secret. Anchovy's loaded with salt.
So
the
don't
olives,
add more.
Olives are loaded with salt.
And the capers.
And the capers. But is it too much salt?
No, it's
okay,
delicious.
Okay, good. Okay, you scared me for a minute.
No, that was wonderful. But you're going to show us an even more wonderful dessert using the leftovers.
Yes, using our leftovers, yes.
Chef Christoph,
leftover ingredients.
Absolutely, the best way to go. You guys, back to you.